Hey, you know how everybody says that the money is in the list when it comes to email and stuff? Well, if that were 100% true, then spammers would be the richest people in the world because they have like the biggest lists. Instead, the money is really in the relationship with the list. And what ends up happening is usually like we'll get emails to subscribe, you know, like people finally get on our list or whatever, and we send them some emails and they don't immediately buy our stuff. So it becomes discouraging. And then we'll either like just not email very much at all because we're like, well, what's the point? You know, it didn't work. Or we'll do the classic internet marketing thing where we'll send like 9 zillion emails in one day saying, you got to order this thing right now or else it's the end of the world. I've done it myself. Everybody loves that, except they don't. Neither one of those approaches work. If you ignore your list, they're never going to buy anything because you're not like telling them to. And if you email them a billion times and you're super obnoxious, they're like going to maybe buy stuff in the short term, but they're going to get tired of it. So what do you do? Well, the solution is an AI hack. And I know I'm psychic. I can already feel like the skepticism going, I don't know about this AI business. Dude, I get it. This is different because in this video, we're going to spend about 13 minutes, give or take, and we're going to force AI to learn everything about what you sell, your business, your brand, your offer, etc. And we're going to force it to write an email sequence to get your list to go do what you want them to do. And it's going to sound exactly like you, but better, because it's going to sound like you, but a top tier, super expensive, hardcore direct response email copywriter writing like you for you. And like I said, we're going to do all this in about 12 and a half, 13 minutes. We'll see. It's going to be really short. All right, let's get it to work. So let's say that I need to send an email to my list telling them to go watch this YouTube video that I made recently called The Art of Storytelling, How to Create Stories That Sell. This video happens to be doing like killing two birds with one stone because I really do need to send an email to my list, a whole sequence of emails to my list about this. We got a couple choices, right? Like I could sit around and try to remember all the cool stuff about this video. It was 21 minutes long and I made it 4 days ago. Anything more than like 15 minutes is already outside of my memory. Or we could get AI to find all the cool stuff about this video. And that's what we're gonna do, because we don't wanna just write one email. I wanna like write an email, tell them to go check it out. If they don't open it, I wanna send them another one like, hey man, go check this thing out, because they didn't even see the first one. And then if they don't open that one, I wanna send them a third one. So I wanna get 3 emails out about this thing. Writing those manually would take forever. So the simple way to do it is to come over here to the video, and you can get like the transcripts to any video that you want. If it's your own content that's on Wistia or something, or if it's just already pre-written content, it doesn't matter. We just wanna find these transcripts and we want to copy them all. So over here in the YouTubes, I'm gonna leave the timestamps on here. We could toggle them off, but I'm gonna leave them on because I want the email to tell people the timestamps of all the cool stuff that they can see in the video. So, you know, like old school ads for books or whatever, it'd be like, oh, discover where the lost secret of, you know, Guatemala is on page 37. Well, we can write cool stuff like that in our emails about our content and be like, okay, at the 20 minute mark, you're gonna learn X. And at the 4 minute mark, you're gonna learn Y and Z, right? So I got all this stuff copied and now I'm gonna use this tool, and we're doing triple duty now in this video, because I'm gonna promote my own AI writing tool. It's called oJoy.ai. So we could type, but I like talking to this thing by clicking the record button because it's just easier and it's hard for me to type because I'm old and I've been sitting in a computer for 25 years. So here we go. I'm gonna give you the transcripts to a YouTube video, and I want you to read the transcripts and make sure that you understand everything that's being taught in the video, and let me know when you're done. Don't write anything yet. I just want you to let me know that you've learned everything you can about this video. Okay, so I say that, it'll transcribe it there for me, and then I will paste my transcripts. First, I'll say transcripts like that, makes it work a little better, and I'll paste them. Awesome. So it's like, all right, man, cool. We're good to go. So now what I'm going to do is I don't want to just stop there. I want it to find every imaginable cool benefit that someone could experience from watching this video. So check this out. Now, I want you to think like a marketer right now, and I want you to go through these transcripts, and I want you to find every imaginable cool benefit that the viewer can get and or experience as a result of watching this. Because ultimately we're gonna try to convince people to go watch this video. So read the transcripts again and just kind of make an outline of every imaginable cool benefit that you have noticed here. Alrighty, so we'll do that. I'll let it work its magic there, transcribe my rambling, and it'll come up with these benefits for us. And it did a great job. It just basically outlined all the cool stuff that people are going to learn in this video. That's a nice little start and everything, but we still need like really good emails written. So check this out. All right. Now, what I can do is, because oJoy is trained like a marketer and is trained on my stuff and a lot of direct response principles, I can say, what I need you to do is now go through the transcripts again and make a list of almost like bullet points of all of the cool things that they're going to learn and put a timestamp by them. So for example, I'm making this up, but for example, if at the 5 minute mark, they learn how to come up with a story idea in 30 seconds or less, then say something like, at the 5 minute mark, you'll learn how to come up with stories ideas in 5 minutes or less, or whatever. You know what I mean? Here you go. So I had this made for myself before I decided to like offer it to the rest of the world. And we built it so it would understand my completely psychotic ramblings, which is really helpful because if you're like me and you don't want to type forever, or you're ADHD like I am and so forth, then you can just talk to it and it'll write stuff for you. And you don't have to worry about sounding perfect or getting the prompt right, which is really helpful. So this is all cool. We got timestamp bullet points. So here we go. All right. Now what I want to do, we're not writing anything yet. We're going to start. All right. So I'm just like making sure it knows the benefits and kind of refamiliarizing myself with this thing that I recorded 4 days ago. And now we'll say this. Cool. So now what I want you to do is, I need to write an email that's going to my subscribers and they already know me, and I need to tell them to go watch this video. And the email needs to tell them all the reasons why they should go watch the video. Here's what you're going to discover in the video. So using the information that you gave me, write a good email for me that gets people to go and watch it. Now, while it's thinking and doing its stuff here, this is important. But whenever I'm doing stuff with AI, I'll let it write a rough draft first, and then I'll tell it to go back and fix it. If you're trying to mess with the style and tone of the writing and write at the same time, it'll drive you nuts and you won't get much done. So, for example, like I would never say, hey there, but that's okay. The AI doesn't know who to make it out to, so that's fine. Here you go. This is all good. And this is what I'm looking for, okay? The main bullets and the main benefits and everything. I'm going to now mess with it a little bit, and I'm gonna get it to write our three emails for this sequence, rough drafts only, don't really care about the style yet. And then I'll show you a little trick to make it super cool, so it like really writes hardcore. So first thing I'll do is I'll just tell it to make a couple of edits. So this wrote this thing, it's pretty good. This is like kind of aggravating to me because I want the timestamps to be after the fact here. So I'll go ahead and do that. And I'll also tell it this. This is pretty cool. Go ahead and find me like five more really big benefits to go with this video, like five more cool things that they're gonna discover in it. And instead of having the timestamp at the beginning of the bullet point, write the bullet point like, discover how a college professor made millions with simple story-based ads that cost a fortune and worked anyway, and then put the timestamp after that, all right? And why people pay $600 for this swipe file and how to get it free, I would write that as how to get a $600 swipe file of extremely rare stories that sold for free, and then I would put the timestamp after that. So just make slight adjustments there, but most importantly, find me a couple more benefits and put the timestamp afterwards, almost like you were writing a bullet point for a sales letter. That's the thing. So if I had to sit down and type that, it was 1 minute exactly of me talking. If I had to sit down and type that, I wouldn't even do it. It'd be like, it's like why people don't write emails, because you don't have to sit down and like figure out what to say and all of that. So the ability to talk for me anyway is really important. Okay. It gave me more benefits, which is cool. It did the timestamps properly, which is cool. And so I'm gonna say, go ahead and put that in a full email for me. Keep it to the point, don't make it too long. Just heavy benefits, go watch this now. Here's what you're gonna learn, this is cool, etc. So notice, and this is where people can like really hose themselves up with AI, forgot to hit send there, is that we didn't accept the first thing, you know? Like you can go back and make AI work harder for you, and it's meant for you to be the driver. You don't just blindly take what it writes for you and use it unless it just happens to be immediately good, which interestingly, that happened in our last video. It was great. We didn't have to edit anything. So here we go. This is pretty solid. Okay. Remember, I'm not editing the writing style yet. I just want to get the email out. So now that one's pretty good. Here's what we're going to say now. Okay, cool. So now I need two more emails that basically say the same thing, but slightly differently. The first email is going to go out on day one. The second email is going to go out on day two to people who didn't open the first one. The third email is going to go out on day three to people who didn't open the first and second emails. So we need to make the same points in here. Just don't make them identical, please. All right, so it's going to write some. And again, can't stress it enough. Don't care about the style yet. Don't care about the writing tone. I just want to make sure that our ingredients are there, which is like, here's what I got. Here are the benefits. Here's what to do. That's all pretty good. And now it's writing the full sequence for us, which is perfect. Okay. So I'm going to let it finish. And now what we're going to do is I'm going to say this. And this is where I call this activating beast mode. All right. If you do this, it'll take whatever copy that you have and it'll turn it into like way better direct response style copy, which is cool. So here's the trick. It'll work with emails, sales letters, anything. Now what I want you to do is I want you to come up with five hyper-aggressive, curiosity-invoking, hardcore direct response subject lines for each email. So I need five of those for each email and make them really like use every imaginable direct response trick that just make sure that it's something that the reader would absolutely have to open. It would invoke so much or induce whatever the word is, so much curiosity that they wouldn't be able to help themselves. They would absolutely have to read this thing. Now, this is where it gets cool, okay? So these may or may not be good subject lines. That really doesn't matter yet. It is now shifting gears here and getting it into hardcore sales copy writing stuff, because all an email really is, every little piece of an email is a little bit of sales copy. The subject line just sells them on opening the damn email. The body copy of the email sells them on the click. And then, of course, the thing that they click on sells them on whatever the next action step is. So here we go, okay? Dude, all of these are good. So it's like, okay, let's just pick one. But these are all ridiculously good. All right, I love the swipe file leak. That's true, by the way. The swipe file I was talking about in the video, I show you where people are trying to sell it for $600. You can just get it for free. It's nothing to it. This is amazing. All right, so what we got to do is we have to pick one. All right, for email number one, I'm going to choose subject line number one. For email number two, I'm going to choose subject line number two. And for email number three, I'm going to choose subject line number two. Cool. Now, it's got my headlines here, all right, or my subject lines rather. Now what we want to do, and this is like the coolest little trick here, is this. Now I want you to take each email and make it match the style and tone of each of its corresponding subject lines. And I want you to make the email accurately live up to the expectations that are set by the subject lines. What this is going to do is now it's going to take our fundamentally okay emails that it made, and it's going to rewrite them like a real hardcore marketing person. And dude, look at this. This is ridiculous how great this is. So this is so much better than if I just had to sit down and write it, because it's at the end of the day. Oh man, I'm going to be lazy. It's only email. Dude, email is so important. So email number one, weird professor's $10 ads made millions. I stole his framework. True, by the way, this guy made so much money. Hopefully I'll remember to link the video to the little thingy here on the YouTubes. All right. Hey, I stumbled onto something crazy. There's this Purdue professor who made millions selling $10 books using nothing but tiny newspaper ads. No internet, no targeting, just simple story-based ads. It crushed it for 15 straight years. I reverse engineered his entire framework and turned it into an AI template. Here's what I reveal in this video. This is awesome. All right, so I don't really need to do any extra work in here because everything it's saying is accurate. It is correct based on the actual transcripts of the YouTube video we're telling them to go watch. So whether you have a webinar or you want people to go watch a video sales letter or you want people to buy a book or go check out a sales page for a book or whatever, you can use this exact same approach of going like, hey, read all this stuff about my thing, find all the cool benefits and write me some emails for it. And then like slowly but surely, we just did, turn them from normal person emails to hardcore sales conversion driven emails and direct response style emails that sound pretty cool. And we did all of that with the Project Shepherd tool in oJoy.ai. You can try it for free. at oJoy.ai. Free, I tell you. Like, what are you going to do? Like, why would you not try it for free? Would you rather have crappy emails or like type all day and be like miserable doing that? Of course not. There's no fun in that. Ain't nobody got time for that. Go to oJoy.ai and try it. And let me know in the comments if you found this helpful, and let me know what you want me to show you how to do next. I like making these videos for y'all.